Hello children, in the last video already we have learned about the plant life. In today's video we will learn next chapter, that is animal life. We know that the life always starts with a reproduction. To start the another one new life, there must be a reproduction. Maybe in the plants also and maybe in the animals also. Then how in the plants the reproduction took place? In the similar way, the reproduction will take place in the animals also. Then, the life of the animals will begin with reproduction. Then, we know that animals, there are variety of animals on this earth. They are going to give birth to their young babies or young ones. And some animals and some birds and the insects are there. They are going to lay the eggs. And inside the eggs, babies will come out. Then these are the two types of giving birth to the reproduction of the animals. There are some category of animals including human being, dog, cat and elephant, horse, donkey, monkey. These all are the animals will come in a group which are going to give birth to the direct babies. But some animals are there. For example, snake, frog, turtle, crocodile and the birds and the insects. Those all are going to lay the eggs first. And then from inside the egg, there will be a baby. After some time, after hatching of the egg, hatching means what? I'll explain you. They will break the egg shell and they will come out. Babies will come out. Then this second type of the animals. We can see like these two types of animals. Then for second type of animals, those lays eggs. They are going to lay the eggs. First they will lay the egg and then from the egg, the baby will come out. Those animals are called as oviparous animals. Repeat after me, oviparous animals, oviparous animals. What are oviparous animals then? Animals which lay egg to give birth to their young babies are called as the oviparous animals. Example, snake, birds, insects, a frog, fish, crocodile, turtle, etc. Then this hatching. Once the hen or the bird, it has laid eggs, after laying the eggs, it will keep some for some time and it is going to give heat for temperature for those eggs. After getting some amount of temperature, those eggs are going to break. After breaking the eggs, the babies will come out. Because inside, with the help of that temperature, the inside process will take place to become a small bird or an insect inside the egg. It will become a young, complete young one insect. And after maturity time, they are going to come out. They are breaking the egg shell and they will come out. And this whole process, that is the heat or temperature is given by the parent or mother bird or an animal. After getting the temperature, the egg shell is going to break and the baby will come out. This process is called as hatching. Okay. Then we can see some examples here. For example, the life cycle of the cockroach. Isn't it? The reproduction, how the reproduction takes place, how it will become young and how it is going to give birth to the young baby and how it is going to die. We know that the reproduction of human being, he will give birth to the direct young baby and the baby will be there and the childhood and the adult and the aged, medium aged and the aged and last death. Isn't it? Similarly, even the insects also are having the life cycle. For example, if I take the cockroach, we can see cockroach very easily our surrounding. The cockroach, life cycle of the cockroach. First, this big cockroach, adult cockroach is going to lay the eggs. First, it is going to lay the eggs. First process is eggs. After, from the egg, another one. It's not a big cockroach. But it is half matured and the half grown part of the egg will come out from the egg and it is called as a nymph. So this nymph, it is also just like a cockroach only, but it will be a bit different from the adult cockroach. Then this egg, from egg the nymph will come out. from by breaking the egg shell, and this nymph will keep on eating, keep on growing till some time it will be enjoying its life. Okay, it will be eating, it will be keep on growing, and along with that it is going to shed off its old skin. That how the snake will do, know how they, it's by itself only it is going to remove its skin, snakes. Similarly, this nymph, that is before cockroach, the second stage is nymph. Then it is also going to shed off the old skin or remove out the old skin for several times, not only once or twice, several times till it become the adult cockroach. Then this process, shedding of old skin of a nymph, is called as moulting. We call this one as a moulting. Shedding off of old skin of a nymph is called as moulting. I hope you have understood whatever we have discussed in today's video, and if that was the type of the animals which lay eggs and which give birth to the babies, and which lay eggs are called as the oviporous, and which give birth to the young babies are called as a viviporous. Next you may learn in this lesson, and what is hatching you have learned, what is moulting you have learned, and the life cycle of the cockroach you have learned. The cockroach is going to lay the eggs. Inside the egg, the nymph will come out, and till some age the nymph is going to keep on growing, and it will remove its old skin till it becomes the adult cockroach. And again, once it reaches the adult stage, again it is going to lay the eggs, again the nymph, and again the adult cockroach. So like this cycle will be continuing. Okay, so before ending this video, I will give you homework. Write down what are oviparous animals and give examples, and what is hatching also you have to write, and what is molding also you have to write. I hope you will do this homework, and in the next video we'll discuss about the next life cycle of the other animals or the insects. Okay, bye bye.